What's up, guys? It's Tom. Welcome back to the lab. Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to my life. Now, today's video is very much a how to help you out kind of deal. I recently had someone in the comment section of a previous video ask me how to set up conversion tracking in Facebook's ad platform. So today, that's exactly what we're going to do. I'm going to show you how to set up conversion tracking on your landing page using Facebook's ad platform so that you can track using your Facebook pixel who is converting from your ads to drive traffic to your Spotify profile. Now, what is conversion tracking? In short, it's basically a way to set up a system of steps that tells Facebook exactly what you want people to do when they see your ad. In our case, what we want to do is we want people to see the ad, click on it, go to our landing page, and then when they go to the landing page, we want them to click a button to either go to Spotify or Apple Music, and then go to that platform to listen to our song. And what we want to do is tell Facebook that the number one thing we want people to do is to click through on one of those buttons once they reach our landing page. That's how we want to optimize our campaign so that we get the most bang for our buck. You want to ensure that the people who are seeing your ad are actually ending up on Spotify. So that's why we want to set up conversion tracking and we want to use a conversion campaign. Before we dive into all that, I want to remind you, as always, to please subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell icon so you get notified when I post a video, and like and share this video if you're digging it. I would really appreciate it. And I think that you will enjoy what I keep putting out. Hopefully, I'm going to keep trying my best. So moving on. So setting up conversion tracking in Facebook's ad manager. The first way I'm going to show you is by using Facebook's event setup tool. We're here in the ad platform, and the first thing we're going to do is go to these nine little dots on the top left that's labeled business tools. You're going to go to the events manager. Once we're there, we're going to go to settings on the far right at the top. Scroll down and go to open event setup tool underneath the heading event setup. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to put in the address of the landing page that we're sending people to from our ad. So when they see our stories ad on Instagram, Facebook Messenger, when they click listen now, this is the page that they're going to land on. So that's the address we want. I've already got a test page pulled up that I made just for this video, and I'm going to copy the address and we're going to enter the website URL here, paste, and click open website. After a second, the event setup tool pops up on the web page here, and we can set up our conversion tracking for what we want to do. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to click track new button, and we're going to click one of these buttons. There are two of them. We're going to click the top one that says listen, and we're going to select an event. I'm going to scroll all the way down to the bottom of the list and click view content, because that's the event we want to optimize for. Basically, what that is when they click the button, they are choosing to view the content that is behind that button. So that's what we want them to do. We're going to confirm. And then just like that, the setup is complete. The view content conversion has been created and we can finish setup. Finish. Skip that, don't need it. It's gonna automatically close the window and the conversion is done. It's that simple. That's one way. Now, another way you can do it is to set up a custom conversion for the URL that is embedded in that button. You can only do this if you're using a URL that is on your domain. So what I have done is I've created custom URLs with my Facebook pixel embedded in them using a platform called Pixel Me. If you want to go check out Pixel Me, there's a link in the description of this video that you can go give it a look. Basically, in short, what it allows you to do is take your Spotify profile URL, create a redirect with your own branded domain URL. In my case, it's social.tomdupreeiii.com/Spotify, and that URL forwards to my Spotify profile. And because I'm using that redirect, I can create a custom conversion off of that. To do that, I'm here in settings where we were with the event setup tool. I'm going to go to the left side. I'm going to expand this. I'm going to go to custom conversions. As you can see, I've already got a few custom conversions made, but we're going to go ahead and make a test one for this video. So we're going to create custom conversion. We'll name it Spotify test. And we're going to use my pixel, all URL traffic, URL contains. This is an important distinction. You want to put URL contains, not equals, because if you add UTM parameters, it's going to tag those onto the end of URL of your URL, and then the URL isn't going to equal just the one thing. So you want to put contains. In this case, we want to put social.tomdupreeiii.com/Spotify. So that's what the URL contains. And what we would do is we would click create. But in this case, I've already got one called Spotify conversion that does that very thing. So we're going to cancel out of this. And this one, Spotify conversion, is the one that we just made for all intents and purposes. Now, we've got two separate conversion events set up. One view content event, which is a standard event, and then we've got a custom conversion event set up. So let's test them to make sure that they work. So we've got the landing page set up here. It's already pulled up. We're going to go back to data sources. And once we're on data sources, we're going to go to test events. And now that we're on test events, what we're going to do is we're just going to go ahead and reload this page and see what happens. In theory, boom, it should pop up. Now, a standard event has popped up using the page view, and then I've also created a custom conversion for the landing page, which has fired as well. So now we want to test our events on the buttons. So we're going to click through to this button to go to my Spotify profile, which it does. Go team. And as you can see, the view content event that we've set up has just fired, as well as the Spotify conversion custom event that I made as well. So what that does is it allows us two opportunities to target depending on what we want to do. Now let's test the Apple Music one. Take me to the Apple Music profile. There it is. And as you can see, again, the view content conversion has fired once again. And now my Apple Music custom conversion has fired, which I created previously, just like the Spotify one. So again, this gives us options depending on what we want to optimize for. The reason I like having these options, even if I don't use them all the time, it's good to be collecting the data about them, because if I ever want to direct an ad campaign solely at people who listen to music on Apple Music, I'll have that data that I can hyper-target those people for the exact platform I want to send them to. By optimizing just for the view content one, I can optimize for anybody who has clicked through to listen to my music anywhere. And then the reason I created one for the landing page views is if I just want to gather data on people who are going to the landing page but not converting, I can do that as well. So I can retarget the people who get to the landing page but don't convert through, can just retarget them. So it's good to have data on what's happening at every level. That way you get a better picture of how your ads are performing and you can retarget more effectively. So now that we've set up these multiple events, and now that we've figured out how to get them to trigger and we've tested them, let's set up an ad in the ad platform. So we're going to go back up to the business tools section here, go to ads manager, and we're just going to create a new campaign. We're going to optimize for conversions in our campaign objective. We're just going to click continue. And then where this happens is at the ad set level. So we're going to go to the ad set here, and we're going to go to this little section right here under conversion that says pixel. Select my pixel, or in your case, your pixel, obviously, and select a conversion event. Now here's where we get to choose which one we want to use, which is awesome. So if we select the view content event, this is anybody who has clicked a button on our landing page. Anybody who went to listen to music on any platform, this is them. If we want just people who went to Spotify, we can select the Spotify custom conversion that I made that is only those people who went to Spotify from the landing page. In the same fashion, we can do the Apple Music conversion, and we can also target just the people who have converted to the landing page but did not convert through. Now, in the Must Be Dreaming landing conversion, it's just people who showed up on the landing page. It doesn't say whether or not they then went through or not. But what you can do is create a custom audience of the people who did go through and exclude them from your targeting so that you don't hit them as well. Depends on what you want to do and what your goals are with your ads. So that's it. We'll select view content. And then from there, you just go through the ad setup process as normal, and your ads will focus on the people who are most likely to convert for the view content conversion that you set up using the event tool on Facebook ads. There are a few things that can go wrong when setting this up. So I want to share those that I've experienced and how to troubleshoot them. Number one, disable your ad blocker. I know that may sound stupid, but I left mine on and I couldn't figure out why it wasn't working. So make sure before you go to set any of this up that your ad blocker is disabled on all pages for the time being if you have one in your browser. Number two, make sure that your browser has popups enabled if it's not working. So for example, you might input your web address into the event setup tool and click through to your landing page and try to set up your conversions, and you're waiting for the conversion setup tool to come up, but it doesn't, and you end up with a message like this: a pixel wasn't detected on this website. Allow pop-ups. That might be the reason for that. A third reason for that that I ran into is your pixel might be installed on your website in multiple locations. For me, I had the pixel in the header of my website, and I also had it in Google Tag Manager. So what I did was delete it from Google Tag Manager, and then the event setup tool worked just fine. I don't know why it does that, but it's somehow a redundant setup that makes the pixel fire incorrectly. And then lastly, the one that I ran into most recently is that when putting in the URL like this, it didn't work. And oddly enough, if I put the secure URL in there and click open website, it works just fine. So if there's no S at the end of HTTP on your web address and it's not working, try adding the S and maybe that'll clean it up too. These are just a few of the problems I've run into with using the event setup tool. I would also recommend, if you're using Chrome, to install here the Facebook Pixel Helper. It's really helpful and has helped me identify some issues that I've been having on my site as well. So try that. It's super useful and it will tell you what's going on. So that's it for this video. I hope this is really helpful. I hope that I didn't breeze over anything too quickly. Setting up for conversions is super effective. It is a great way to run your ads, especially if you're using a landing page. The argument has been presented that you don't get as much traffic compared to maybe like a link click campaign, but you're vetting your traffic more appropriately on the front end and you're getting higher quality traffic. Additionally, the retargeting for a conversion-based audience is much more effective because you've already outlined the specific steps that you want your audience to take. Those people have taken them so that when you retarget them, they're much more likely to re-engage with your content or engage with new music that you have coming out. That's it. I hope it's helpful. If you have any questions about this, let me know in the comments. Hit me up. You can DM me on Instagram too, and make sure to check out Pixel Me in the description below. It'll be all down there if you want to try that out. It's a really dope service. I love it. I've been using it for a while now, and I think it's pretty tight. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.